What's up, YouTube? You guys are watching Boxing Talk with Shaka Waka. What's going on, everybody? Yo, I just wanted to speak on, you know, Espn ranking Terrence Bud Crawford as the number third welterweight, being a Terrence Bud Crawford fan. But before I get into this, I want to say thank you to everybody who comes and likes and comments on my videos. And shout out to my subscribers, y'all the real ones. And also shout out to the LDBC. Let's get it. Now, let's go ahead and speak on this. Okay. So, man, I hear a lot of back and forth about, you know, Terrence Crawford being ranked the third welterweight in the division. And I just want to give my take on the situation, knowing that I am a huge Terrence Crawford fan, being here from Omaha, Nebraska, okay, 402, you know what I'm saying? Let me quick climb. But anyway, you know what, I ain't mad at ESPN at all. Let's be real. Terrence Crawford can have all the skill in the world right now. He has done great things at 140, becoming undisputed champion down there. But this is a whole new weight class, bro. This is a whole new weight class with different killers, different other people that have proven themselves already. Number three, to me, is being generous to the kid. Honestly, because if you really want to think about welterweights, we're not talking pound for pound. You get the difference here. We're talking about just the welterweight division, and this is how they have them ranked: Errol Spence, Manny Pacquiao, Terrence Crawford, Keith Thurman, then Sean Porter. Honestly, in my opinion, if you want to rank just the welterweights, you can honestly put, you can switch Terrence Crawford and, not Manny Pacquiao, switch Terrence Crawford and Sean Porter. Terrence Crawford could be in the fifth spot, and Sean Porter could have that third spot. That's how I feel. You know, you could play around a little bit with Sean Thurman, because, you know, Thurman beat Porter. So you could switch them around and have Thurman as the number three. You know what I'm saying? You could do that. So I'm not mad at all by Terrence Crawford being number three. I actually think they're being a little bit generous. I don't know. I keep hearing people saying that Terrence Bud Crawford fans is tripping and shit. Don't know why. I ain't heard none of that. Because if you really think from a logical standpoint, Terrence Bud Crawford ain't did nothing on the level as these other fighters have done. You know what I'm saying? He was undisputed at 114. Junior welterweight. That ain't welterweight. Okay? That ain't welterweight. Keith Thurman has been a unified champion before. Sean Porter has fought every fucking body. Manny Pacquiao is a legend. And Errol Spence dominates everybody he gets in the ring with. And he's about to have a unified fight with Sean Porter. So, things that Terrence Crawford has done at the welterweight division does not stack up to any of these fighters. Let's be real. He could be in the fifth position. So him being in the third spot, you know, is giving him a little something. I think they did that because he is with top rank ESPN. Because literally, if you really want to say where Terrence Crawford should be in the welterweight division, it should be the fifth spot. Because he really hasn't fought anybody on the caliber as Sean Porter. Sean Porter done fought everybody. You know what I'm saying? Manny Pacquiao has fought everybody. Keith Thurman has fought who he needed to fight. You know what I'm saying? Only loss coming to Manny Pacquiao. You know what I'm saying? Errol Spence, he's been ducked at the division, but he is the IBF champion, and he is not defeated. You know what I'm saying? And he about to unify with Sean Porter. I can't stress that enough. You know what I'm saying? I really don't think people are understanding. People think, oh, Terrence Crawford, he's getting gypped. He's getting gypped. But I really sat there and thought about it. Like, ESPN would be dead ass lying if they put Terrence Crawford at the number one spot. Yeah, that's yeah, that's they fighter. You know what I'm saying? We know fucking Top Rank don't promote Terrence Crawford like that. And he a fool if he signed with them again, period. But we know they would be straight up lying if they put Terrence Crawford over Manny Pacquiao and Errol Spence. Okay? And they reaching, putting them over Sean Porter and Keith Thurman. Period. You could argue that he can be there because he's undefeated. But if you want to go off of resumes and how long they actually been in the welterweight division putting in work, yeah, the Terrence Crawford don't outweigh that. You know what I'm saying? His resume don't outweigh theirs. So I'm not upset at this. You know, they're just telling the truth. Honestly, it's just the truth. And they doing a little bit of a reach. You know what I'm saying? You know what the outrage would be if Terrence Crawford was above Errol Spence right now? Please. Now, that would be a whole ass lie. I would even have to come over here like, nah, y'all tripping. Y'all is tripping. Y'all gonna sit here and say Errol Spence done beat all these motherfuckers, put on a boxing show with Mikey Garcia, fucking drug Cal Brook, to tell me that Terrence Crawford, who only had, he has 3 fights in the welterweight division, he's already above him. Please, man, please. Now, if you want to speak on like a pound for pound shit, you know what I'm saying? Then you can switch up the list. You can argue that Terrence Crawford is that number one person on the list. You know what I'm saying? Because I'll argue that all day because of what he did at 140. You know what I'm saying? I'll argue that all day. He has become undisputed. While in the welterweight division, all these fighters only became unified. You know? Undisputed trumps all that. So I will argue all day about a pound for pound decision, but I can't argue about Terrence Crawford being number 3 on the list. Like, nigga, they being generous. You know what I'm saying? They being generous. And that's coming from a real Terrence Bud Crawford fan, for real. Like, I don't see how anybody could be mad at that, because he can be 2 more spots down. You know what I'm saying? He could be 2 more spots down. And I also want to talk about, you know, the PBC not recognizing the WBO belt. You know what I'm saying? Which is alleged. We haven't really heard anybody from the PBC say this. You know what I'm saying? But let's talk about it anyway. Terrence Crawford holds that WBO belt. And honestly, I can give a shit. Like, to me, if all the fucking promoters was like, yo, we ain't recognizing the WBO belt, nigga, I am gonna be cool with that. Hell, I would rather them take off more belts. Hell, I'm sick of all these belts in boxing. Like, hey, because it just causes way too much confusion and way too much shit. Just, like, it don't matter. Like, the best should just be fighting the best. I don't give a damn what belt you holding, period. We know that belt, the WBO, comes from Top Rank. You know what I'm saying? That straight Bob Arum shit. And it's only Top Rank fighters that be getting ranked for that damn belt. So why should the PBC recognize if none of their fighters are getting ranked for the belt? Like, that's common sense. Why would they recognize it if none of the fighters are getting ranked for the belt? Like, you got 3 other belts over here they can be getting ranked for. We ain't missing shit with the WBO, period. Man, period. So I wouldn't be mad. I can't be mad at that. PPC gotta do what the hell they gotta do. They got the fighters over there. So they good, man. They good. Terrence Crawford, you know, he gotta get away from Top Rank, because he's getting mad at the wrong people. You getting mad at PBC for promoting their fighters. Like, you need to be getting mad at your promoter for not promoting you, nigga. That's what you need to be mad at. You know what I'm saying? You mad at the wrong things. Because I'm pretty sure if you was over there on the PBC, those fighters would be trying to fight you. You know what I'm saying? Y'all would be fighting. But you just in a position where you can't win right now. And that's just the honest truth, bruh. Like, that's the honest truth. Terrence Crawford, you my dude, but you got to get away from Top Rank, because they don't mean you no good, man. They don't mean you no good. Man, it's plenty of fights you could have already had, but what's the problem? Bob Arum, Top Rank, other sides of the street, You know what I'm saying? We ain't gonna act like that don't exist, man. We ain't gonna act like that don't exist. Because if it didn't, we wouldn't be talking about it. Period. Just like how motherfuckers be like racism don't exist. Then how we talking about it, bruh? How are we talking about it? You know? So let me know what you guys think in the comment section. Like, comment, and subscribe. And thank you guys for watching. Peace.